Gas cylinders are made from seamless tubing or from flat sheets of drawn steel shaped into a cylinder. Some common types we see when we are using compressed gases, we have the ICC-3A cylinders, which are made of seamless high pressure tubing. Those cylinders could withstand 150 to 15,000 pounds per square inch gauge. We have also the ICC-3AA, which is a seamless high pressure cylinder that is above 3A rating. We have something called ICC-3B. It's a seamless high pressure. It can hold gases with a pressure of 150 to 500 PSIG. We have the ICC-3E. It's a 2-inch maximum diameter with 24-inch maximum length, and it can withstand 1800 PSIG, which is, again, pound per square inch gauge. The last type is ICC-8, and it's seamless low pressure. It can withstand 250 PSIG for acetylene surfaces, which is the cylinders used for cooking. The gas cylinders are dangerous, and if mishandled, they can result in fire and explosions. It's important to understand what is written on the these cylinders. We have something called marking on the gas cylinders. The first line, you will see what is the specification of the which type of cylinder we are dealing with, and as well as the date and how much pressure pounds per square inch gauge. And the second, number of the cylinder. The third line is the manufacturing marking. And the fourth line is the month and year of qualification test. This is a general idea of what the markings on the gas cylinder means. Gas cylinders are usually used in hospitals and clinics and healthcare institutions through a piping system. And we have different ways and schematics of these piping systems. It's important for all biomedical engineers who work in the hospital to understand what those schematics and how they're important and how the cylinders are providing gas to the different parts of the hospital. We have central oxygen cylinders supply oxygen to specific areas through pressure regulating valves. And that maintains a pressure between 50 to 100 PSI, which is, again, pound per square inch, and the service outlet. Please keep in mind that the main supply must have shut-off valves and an alarm system. We should have separate station manual or automatic shut-off valves are all should be required. Also, all personnel must be educated as to the placement and use of these valves on the cylinders. What kind of therapeutic gases usually are used in ventilators and respirators? So we have oxygen, which is an essential, you know, gas for life, and it normally makes 21% of the room air. We have carbon dioxide. It's important to control the respiration and circulation, and it's usually 0.025% of the room air. We use also helium. It's a lightweight inert gas used in cases of respiratory obstruction. People also use nitrous oxide, which is an inorganic gas used as an anesthetic agent. We have helium oxygen mixtures, and it's a low density gas used for patients with asthma. Also, we have oxygen carbon dioxide mixture, and that is this gas is used to stimulate deep breathing and to relieve cerebral vascular spasm. And as I mentioned before, these cerebral vascular spasms actually are the result of the contraction of the smooth muscles that are surrounding the vessels, the blood vessels of arteries and veins.